have a look at an example of a paper describing a randomised controlled trial. This was a randomised controlled trial I ran with my research group here at the University of Queensland. We were evaluating a cognitive behavioural intervention for treating children with an anxiety disorder. But we already had evidence that the intervention itself was efficacious. So our focus in this trial was on the efficacy of different delivery modalities of the intervention. The intervention itself consisted of 6 sessions for the parents and 6 sessions for the children. The children had to be 7 to 14 years of age, and they had to meet the criteria for at least 1 clinically significant anxiety disorder. We had 3 conditions, and people were randomly assigned to 1 of these 3. The first condition was the waitlist control condition, where participants received no treatment for 12 weeks. The second condition was the clinic-based individual therapy condition, where families came into the clinic for the intervention on a one-on-one basis. The third condition was the therapist-supported bibliotherapy condition, where the parents received a brief training in the intervention and then worked through the entire 12-week program at home with regular telephone support from their therapist. The intervention used in the 2 active treatment conditions was the same. The differences were about who and how it was delivered.